Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. For the standard SpaceX updates today, we have some upcoming launches and new launch contract information. Then over to Boca Chica to see the usual infrastructure updates as well as more delays to SN6 plus future Starships. So let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting off, we have a tweet from space reporter Michael Sheets. He tweeted, Masten Space Systems signed a contract with SpaceX to launch the Masten Mission 1 to the Moon in 2022, with the XL-1 lander set to deliver 9 payloads to the lunar south pole under NASA's CLPS program. In the last video, we had an interesting launch schedule for SpaceX with two Falcon 9s and a Starship expected to lift off within a few days of each other. SpaceX then had to delay and started targeting today for back-to-back Falcon 9 launches. In response to that tweet, they mentioned that the weather was quite unfavourable with 50% for Starlink and 40% for Sayacom 1B. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, these two launches appear to still be on the table for today. So about when the time this video is uploaded and later into the evening, there could be two separate Falcon 9s launching out of Florida. So with all those standard SpaceX updates covered, let's head to Boca Chica and check out some infrastructure changes. First of all, you will likely know that the company has recently been erecting a wall outside the test area. They are continuing to progress with this with the addition of more shipping containers and more metal panels. Just behind the wall and behind the launch mount is the newest mount down at Pad B. Many people pointed out my mistake in the last video, but you can see here that the thrust simulators have been installed. Engineers are progressing with the mount still as they work to prepare it for the Starship tank that will be tested. I believe what they will want to test on here is probably going to be SN7.1. Over by the Super Heavy launch mount, which Musk confirmed as being a mount and not a water tower, work is progressing. You can see that they have added more rebar for the support of the launch mount. To add to this, another one of the tubes has been sleeved, shall we say, with some of the rebar. I can't wait until we get to see how this structure will actually look once complete, hopefully in a couple of months or so. Nearer to the production area of the facility, we have some work going on with the ground. Looks like the work they are doing here is by the old gas well lot that we've seen here and there recently. Also, actually inside the construction yard, the 81 meter tall high bay for Super Heavy has been under construction. With work on the final half level already underway and almost complete, we are getting very close to the high bay being done. I'm sure within the next couple of weeks to a month, the whole structure will probably be complete and ready for action. Now that the infrastructure updates have been covered, let's take a look at a few tweets as well as some bits of Starships spotted. To begin with, Musk was asked by somebody whether or not we can still expect the Starship presentation in September. Musk responded to say, Neuralink this month and Tesla next month, SpaceX probably October, we will have made a lot of progress by then, might have a prototype booster hop done by then. Then, everyday astronaut who always asks the best questions asked about Super Heavy and Raptor engines. He said they could probably get away with 3 or 6 engines for hopping the booster. Musk responded to say that only 2 Raptor engines would be needed to get a Super Heavy off the ground. In response to his own reply, Musk tweeted some more information about Raptor. What he said was, Raptor reached over 500,000 pounds of thrust at peak pressure with some damage, so this version of the engine can probably sustain approximately 210 tons, should have 250 plus ton engine in about 6 to 9 months. Target for booster is 7,500 tons or 16.5 million pounds of thrust. There was one other tweet from Elon Musk in response to somebody tweeting a render of Super Heavy and Starship. Musk said, booster design has shifted to 4 legs with a wider stance to avoid engine plume impingement in vacuum rather than 6. Just before we look at Starship serial numbers, we have a couple of odd pieces of Starships in the works. Firstly, these new tapered nose cone pieces have been spotted outside behind the fabrication tents. Also moved outside was this new nose cone tip, which already has a header tank as you can see it slightly popping out. There's also an interesting box on the side which I don't remember seeing on a nose cone before. Another Starship section, which is a ring stack, was also spotted behind the tents attached to a crane. Whilst I could be wrong, I believe this piece is for the SN7.1 test tank, which I'll show you in just a bit. Before that though, I just wanted to show you a shot of SN5 which was recently moved outside the mid bay. It's still hanging out in the construction yard just outside the mid bay with SN8 still sitting inside waiting for stacking. Last episode we saw the arrival of a new mass simulator for the SN6 prototype. Over the last few days it was hooked up to a crane in order to be lifted and connected with SN6. Whilst engineers were working atop the vehicle in order to prepare it for connecting the mass simulator, it was also lifted and placed onto the upper bulkhead for welding. So with SN6 having now completed its static fire with Raptor SN29 and now obtained a hat, it's near enough ready for the 150 meter hop. Engineers are now working on performing the final checks and doing the final preparations before the flight. Last episode I mentioned we could expect a hop to happen on Friday, which clearly didn't happen. Delays are inevitable and much better to delay than have a rocket go boom. So here are the latest road and beach closures with a primary closure date of today. SpaceX could be testing the prototype as I'm finalizing and uploading this video. With SN6 information out of the way, let's look at SN7.1 and SN8, starting with SN7.1, which has recently been progressing. Here you can see that engineers were getting everything ready to stack two parts of this test tank. Whilst there is no footage of the stacking process, you can see that the leg skirt was welded to another ring stack to form the aft section of the tank. Moving on to SN8 though, last episode we saw a whole load of preparations happening with sections to get ready for stacking. So, the thrust section which we saw stacked was hooked up to a crane. Then, even though there is no footage to show of the process once again, you can see that SN8 has been stacked. Sitting just behind SN5, we now have a fully stacked tank section for SN8, but unlike with other tanks, this isn't where it stops, I hope. We could expect to see SN8 also get fins and a nose cone and be the first full-size Starship since Mark 1, incredibly exciting times. So, just before we finish up the episode, I need to make you all aware of something which I did post as a community post yesterday. Essentially, I'm a full-time web developer and due to the current unfortunate situation in the world, I've been on furlough by the company I work for the last 5 to 6 months. However, on Tuesday, I'll be resuming my full-time job. This should not affect upload days, which for those of you who don't know is Wednesday and Sunday, but will probably affect the upload time on Wednesday. I'll probably only be able to upload Wednesday videos later in the evening around 11 p.m. or midnight here in the UK. I just want to make it abundantly clear, my videos will remain unchanged, it's just to do with the time in which they are uploaded. As is always the case, these detailed and timely updates would not be possible without Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, going out there and filming, so massive thanks to her. Also, the whole NASA spaceflight team does an incredible job behind the scenes, so a massive thanks to them as well. Remember that if SpaceX are testing SN6 today, NSF will definitely be streaming, so make sure to check after this video. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.